Ladies and gentlemen, different setup since the music was just played behind us. My next speaker is my dear friend, Jörg, as I said earlier, the mastermind of the Flying Lab. Jörg, let's talk a little bit about the future. Let's talk about Flying Lab 2.0. 3 years ago, the first Flying Lab, I think, took place between Frankfurt and San Jose, if I correct. And so we're now in the 15th Flying Lab. Usually they consist out of an in-flight conference, as we're seeing it today, with great speakers. Passengers have the possibility actually to look at great products, innovations that are somehow related to the airline industry. There's live performances, as we saw just right now. To me, that was the first time. I thought that was really, really great. But we even had once a fashion show, I think, on board. Unfortunately, yes. I was not invited for that one. Maybe next time I can be part of that. And all of this happened over the clouds. So with Flying Lab 2.0, you will reach the next level. Maybe you can elaborate a little bit and share with our distinguished guest what Flying Lab 2.0 is going to look like.
So yeah, thank you, Olivier. So what is Flying Lab 2.0? So right now we experience this conference, and this conference has always been a starting point for innovation. That was why we had this conference on board. We have great speakers, we have impulses, and we get ideas. So what we do with Flying Lab 2.0, really we put the conference still front and center, but it's part of a whole innovation experience. So starting from a conference with ideation, we get those ideas. We have a concept of how to make ideas, how to look at the ideas, how to decide which ideas we should actually tackle. And then we create real products. Initially, prototypes. We test them back here on board in a flying lab. So as I said, the conference on board stays front and center. But the flying lab of tomorrow is not just a conference. It's really the whole innovation experience, the whole innovation platform for Lufthansa and Lufthansa Airlines.
Thank you, Jörg, for the explanation. It sounds actually great, I have to say, and it fits into the mood of the attempt of so many companies actually who are trying to be more customer-driven, to not only have a look at the specific product they had in mind so far, but also to look at the overall experience, which does not only start in our case with the flight itself, but as I discussed earlier with Guido, far before the flight and then also after the flight. The Flying Lab 2.0 is going to be the innovation platform within the Lufthansa Group. How can people actually be part of it? Today we had a couple of interactive sessions, and I think people are very keen, and it is also part of the concept, I assume. So how do you ensure that people can be part of it?
Right. I mean, it all starts actually with our employees. And you know that because we started 3 years ago, incidentally at the same time, with something at Lufthansa Systems where we integrated the employees in the whole innovation process in a much closer way. We really want to have them and their insights tuned and heard and part of the innovation process. Now, as you said, of course, the passengers are also part of this, and we always do this during a flying lab. We test our products here, we test our ideas, we have questionnaires, we have real products that we try to understand, is that what you really want to use? And we do have a website, flyinglab.io, where we right now announce those conferences on board. But this will be also the exchange platform also to reach passengers that are not here on board and still have their insights coming in. So we really want to integrate our employees, but also all our passengers and potential passengers, and want to hear what are they missing? What are we missing? What should we enhance in our product? What are the pain points of flying? And what are the gain points? What do you really want to see more often? So this is, as I said, Flying Lab 2.0 is a platform for innovation.
Well, this is great, and I would say on the theoretical level also easy to understand, but how do you actually, how does these ideas actually become real products at the end of the day that our customers will then have in hands or experience? How do you want to do that next step?
Exactly. I mean, this is really front and center of what we try to do. If you have an idea, and this idea is so great that a business unit says, hey, great, this solved my problem, or this is what we need in order to have a really new passenger experience. I mean, those ideas are flying. You know, they get being developed, then we have a new product. But how many of those ideas do you really have? How many of the ideas that initially come in are already so clear? So what do we need to do? We need to find all the other ideas that are not so clear in the beginning and give them a chance to develop into something great. So how do we do this? We actually have them on a platform and we ask our employees to vote on them. So a lot of those are probably not worth to try, but it's not us sitting there and saying, oh, good, bad, but it's all of our employees really bringing in their experience, all our flight attendants bringing the experience here with the interaction with the passengers, all our ground staff, all our administrative staff. Everyone can now bring in their knowledge into deciding what is the next best thing. And then based on this, we actually have, we give our employees €1,000, which is initially just virtual money, but it turns into real money when they basically say, this is the idea I want to invest in, and then we do it. And then we have the next step, and then it's still not the product yet, but at least the idea could develop into something that's now understandable, and then we now say, hey, great, this is what we really need, and now we want to progress.
Yeah, and
it's like Kickstarter in the company.
Yes, and I can confirm that actually as a businessman looking into my own role as one of the heads of Lufthansa Systems, we together introduced this type of innovative process into our company, and we've got so much great feedback from our employees, and some of these ideas actually turned into real business cases, and that's what you want to achieve at the end of the day. So,
and lo and behold, I mean, what we have today, the foundation is Board Connect, and this is what came out of the innovation process at Lufthansa Systems. So here we are.
But nevertheless, if we think a little bit beyond an internal initiative, Flying Lab 2.0 is an initiative of Lufthansa. Is there any possibility actually to include external companies, people, individuals to contribute actually and to be part of that process as well?
Sure. I mean, this is, as I said, it's a whole platform. So far we discussed Flying Lab Invent and Flying Lab Create, but there's also what we call Flying Lab Connect. And in Flying Lab Connect, we actually reach out to startups. We want to hear what they have to say, what we are missing out, and want to give them a chance to actually build products with our big organization behind. I mean, always when a startup comes into a huge organization, it's a hassle. There are two different animals trying to work together. Doesn't work always. So we want to actually give them or facilitate that. So this is part of Connect. We also reach out to academia. We have collaborations with universities, and we actually have two EU projects running. So this is how we want to connect. And as I said initially, very core to this is having the exchange with the passengers. And what we have back there, the design lab, the design sprint with Guido, the team of Guido looking into customer centricity, looking at all the different stages of the passenger journey, knowing exactly where are the pain points, getting this from the passengers, talking to many, many passengers during the flight, after the flight, getting all those information. This is also key part of also deciding what should we implement, what is the next product. And so it's great to have Guido back there and actually working on this while on flight. So this is what we want to do.
Jörg, thank you so much for your insights that you provided, and I'm very much looking forward actually to Flying Lab 2.0. I really like so much about the idea actually that we're combining. Indeed, you just brought up the example of the old legacy companies, carriers in the airline industry, but also outside of the airline industry actually, and then the fresh ideas that are also necessary but more fruitful in a startup environment, so to say, and to combine those two, I think this is an amazing platform that allows is the best of two worlds. So in this sense, thank you so much, Jörg,
thank
and
you.
Looking forward to Flying Lab 2.0.